Hello friends, welcome to Time Classes. Today's topic is probability, and the handout that we will be using is QAHO 353-2026. I hope you have this handout with you, but even if you don't, I will be posting the questions on the slide, and so there should not be any problem. To get the most out of this class, I suggest that you have a rough copy nearby for quick solving of questions and also a fair copy to take down the notes. The prerequisite for this topic is permutations and combinations, and I hope that you are clear with that particular topic. Otherwise, today's class is going to be a little difficult. So keeping that in mind, let us begin today's class. So first, let's discuss some basic concepts about probability. Now, what is probability? It is an estimation about the likeliness of an event, whether it will happen or whether it will not happen. So the probability of an event to happen is defined as the number of favorable outcomes divided by the total number of outcomes. And so for any question in probability, these are the two things that you have to calculate. We will look at certain questions where this will become clear to you all. The probability of an event to certainly take place would be one. And that would be when the number of favorable outcomes will become equal to the total number of outcomes. Okay. So, for example, if I toss a coin, then what are the total number of outcomes? There are two possible outcomes. If you toss a coin, it will be either a heads or a tails. So what is the, if I were to ask, what is the probability that when you toss a coin, you will get either a heads or a tails? What is the probability? So what are your favorable outcomes? Heads or tails? So two favorable outcomes. And what are the total number of outcomes? Heads or tails, so two total number of outcomes. So two divided by two will give you one. That is, certainly when you will toss a coin, you are going to get a heads or a tails. And if I were to say, if I were to ask, what is the probability that if you toss a coin, you will neither get a heads nor a tails? So that probability would be zero, because number of favorable outcomes is zero. If you toss a coin, obviously it is supposed to be a heads or a tails. So in that case, the probability of the event becomes zero. That is, the event will definitely not take place. Okay. And from this, it is sufficient to conclude that the probability of an event will always lie between zero and one. That is, it cannot be greater than one and it cannot be negative. So this much should be sufficient for the basics of probability. And now using PNC, we will solve some questions. Please also write down in your copy the example that I just gave you. So let's start with the first example for today. And this one, I will explain it to you so that you know what is going on. Now, when seven coins are tossed, seven different coins, what is the probability of getting exactly three heads? Okay. So first, what would be the total number of outcomes? We always find out the total number of outcomes, and then we go for the favorable number of outcomes. So if you toss seven coins, what would be the total number of outcomes? You toss the first coin. How many options are there? It will be either a heads or a tails. So two possible outcomes. You toss the second coin. Now you get another two outcomes. You toss the third coin, so another two outcomes. So the total number of outcomes becomes 2 × 2 × 2 × 2 × 2 × 2 × 2. That is 2^7. Okay. Now, out of these seven coins, exactly three should be heads. So you can now select those three coins in 7C3 ways. select the three coins which will get a heads. So 7c3 divided by the total number of outcomes, that is 2 raised to the power 7. So 7c3 you have to calculate. That will be 7 factorial by 3 factorial, 4 factorial. So that is 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 factorial divided by 3 factorial, 4 factorial, which is 7 into 6 into 5 divided by 6 factorial, which is 7 into 5, that is 35. So you get favorable outcomes as 35, that exactly 3 heads, select those 3 coins divided by total number of outcomes, that is 2 raised to the power 7. That is your answer. Please write this down. Okay, so let's go to the next question. Now, next question relates to pack of cards. So let's discuss the basics first. In a pack of cards, you will have 52 cards. So I am excluding all jokers. You have four suits. The suits are called hearts, diamond, spade, and clubs. These suits are of two possible colors, that is the hearts and diamonds are of red color and the spade and the clubs are of black color. Please keep making good notes. The number of cards per suit is 13. I just corrected that mistake. Number of cards per suit is going to be 13, and that is why 4 suits, 13 into 4 gives you 52 cards. And you have two types in per suit. You have the number cards and you have face cards. So the number cards per suit is 9, that is from 2 to 10. And the other 4 are called face cards. The face cards are called as Ace, Jack, Queen, and King. Okay. So total face cards in a pack of cards would be 4 into 4, 16. And the number of number cards in a pack of cards would be 9 into 4, that is 36. Please write this down. Okay, so with the basics in place, now let's go to a question on pack of cards. So if three cards are drawn from a well-shuffled pack of cards, what is the probability that each card is a queen? Please solve this in 15-20 seconds. Find the total number of outcomes. Find the favorable number of outcomes. Okay, so total number of outcomes would be 52c3 because from 52 cards you are choosing 3 cards, 52c3. What is the probability that each card is a queen? So that means that we want that all 3 cards should be queens. Can I say that there are 4 queens in the pack? One per suit. So 4 queens in a pack of which you need to select 3 queens. So total favorable total number of outcomes is 52 C3. And the queens that you have to choose are 4c3 out of 4 select 3. So probability becomes 4c3 divided by 52c3. That is 4 divided by 52c3, and that is choice number one. I hope this is okay. Very straightforward question. And the next few questions are also of the easy kind. So just if you have clarity in permutations and combinations, then today's class will not be very difficult. So let's go to the next question. If three cards are drawn from a well-shuffled pack of cards, what is the probability that each card is a diamond suit? So in the previous question, each card had to be a queen. In this question, each card should be a diamond. Please take 15 seconds. Okay, so you want to select three cards, so total number of outcomes will be 52c3, and that is obvious from each of the denominators also. Now the three cards should be diamond. Diamond is one of the suits and it contains 13 cards. So from these 13, you want to select three cards. So 13c3 will be the favorable number of outcomes. So 13c3 divided by 52c3 should be the answer. Okay, next question two from your handout. If six coins are tossed, what is the probability that at least three coins show tail? At least three coins show tail means either three coins can be a tails, or four coins can be showing tails, or five coins can be showing tails, or six coins can be showing tails. Please try this. Okay, so when you toss six coins, what will be the total number of outcomes? It will be 2 raised to the power 6. And what would be the favorable number of outcomes? That is, if three coins show tail, then let me select those three coins, so it will be 6c3. Or four coins may show tail, so it becomes 6c4. Or five coins may show tails, so that becomes 6c5. Or all six coins may show tails, so that becomes 6c6. And these are all dependent events because either three coins will show tails or four. You cannot have three coins also in tails and four coins also in tails. Okay? One of them has to exist. So total number of possibilities is 2 raised to the power 6. And at least three coins being tails is 63 plus 64 plus 65 plus 66. Okay, so what is 63? 63, 6 into 5 into 4, 5 into 4, 20. 63 is 20, 64 is 15, that's 35. 65 is 6, that's 41, and 66 is 1, 42. So the answer should be 42 divided by 2 raised to power 6, that's 64. So 42 divided by 64 becomes 21 divided by 32, that is option number 1. Just select your coins. How many need to be in tails? Make the calculation and it is done. Okay. Total number of outcomes, 2 raised to power 6, as we saw previously. Favorable outcomes, choose 3 coins out of 6, 4 coins out of 6, 5 coins out of 6, 6 coins out of 6. Calculate, divide, we get the answer. Next question 6. Take 30 seconds. Okay, so we want to select 3 cards, so the ways will be 52C 3 ways. Okay, total ways will be 52C 3 ways. And in this pack of cards, you have 4 ace cards and 48 non-ace cards. And you want at least one card to be an ace. So can I say that the probability that at least one card is an ace can also be written as 1 minus probability that no card is an ace. Total number of ways is equal to number of ways in which at least one card is an ace plus number of ways in which none of the three cards is an ace. Let me repeat that. Total number of ways of picking three cards will be equal to the three cards have no ace, plus the three cards have one ace, plus the three cards contain two aces, plus the three cards contain three aces. So, which is the category for at least one card is an ace? One ace, two ace, three ace. Okay? So, now can I write total as one ace, two ace, three aces, at least one card is ace? So now this becomes equal to total number of ways minus no card is an ace. Total minus none of the three cards selected is an ace. Okay. So you can write this as 52C3, total number of ways, minus none of the three cards should be an ace. So 48C3, 52C3 minus 48C3 becomes favorable outcomes. That is, at least one card is an ace, divided by 52C3. Okay. Number of ways of drawing four non-ace cards is 48C3 divided by 52C3. So, at least one card is an ace becomes 52C3, or if you want it in terms of probability, it will become simply 1 minus 48C3 divided by 52C. That is, 1 minus no card is an ace is equal to at least one card is an ace. Write this down. I will give you time to write, so better that initially you focus completely on understanding what I'm saying, and then you can write down. Or sometimes you can write down a little bit and focus on understanding and listening. Okay, for any lecture, the focus has to be on listening and then writing. Next question. Okay, what are the total number of outcomes? First 100 natural numbers, or 100 is the total number of outcomes. And how many multiples of 3 do we have? 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, and so on till 93, 96, 99. So basically, you have 3 into 1 till 3 into 33. So you have 33 multiples of 3. Okay. So 33 is the favorable outcomes, 100 is the total number of outcomes. So your answer should be 33 divided by 100. Again, a very easy question, one step. And next question, number 8. Okay, it is very similar to the previous question. So you have the first 30 natural numbers, so the total number of outcomes becomes 30. And the favorable number of outcomes is that it should be a prime number. Selected number should be a prime number. So I list out all the primes from 1 to 30. So those will be 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29. Yes, you have to count them, and it turns out that there are 10 natural numbers, 10 prime numbers in 1 to 30. So the favorable outcomes becomes 10, the total number of outcomes becomes 30. So 10 by 30 is 1 by 3. That is your answer. Option number 4. I'm sure that you all are being able to understand, and it's just that your permutations, combinations, basics need to be in place. Please make good notes, huh? Mostly everything on the slides should be in your copy. Don't leave anything out. Your notes, you should feel like looking at your notes later. If you don't put the effort into making good notes right now, then you only will not feel like looking at it later. And you then probably won't. And the next question, question number 9. Slightly different question. Go through it carefully. Okay, so basically, you are given a set of consecutive natural numbers from 1 to 15. So the total number of outcomes will become 15. Yes, the probability that the number is a solution of this equation. Now, what do you mean by solution of the equation? Solution of the equation means that LHS should be equal to RHS. That is that there should be a particular value of x put in the left-hand side such that left-hand side becomes equal to 0 and that is equal to the right-hand side. So obviously the values of x would be 2 or 3 or 4. For these three values of x, 2 or 3 or 4, it's a solution. Okay? So you have these three as favorable outcomes out of the total number of outcomes 15. So 3 by 15 becomes 1 by 5. That is choice number 3. Again, very straightforward, but slightly different. Okay. And next question number 17. Now, slightly the difficulty level is going to increase. Please go to question number 17. You have four boys and five girls. You need to make a team of three members, but there should be exactly two girls in that team. So two girls, that means third person will be a boy. So you need to select one boy and two girls for the team. Okay, so your team should have two girls and one boy, and you have a total of nine people, and you need to select three people. So total number of outcomes will become 9C3, and you want to select two girls and one boy. So favorable outcomes will become 5C2, that is selecting two girls, into 4C1, that is selecting one boy. So total outcomes is 9C3. Select two girls, 5C2. Select one boy, 4C1. 5C2 is 10, 4C1 is 4. So 10 into 4 is 40. So probability becomes 40 divided by 84. That is 10 by 20. That is choice number 3. Okay, let's go over this again. Out of nine people, you need to make a team of three people. So 9C3 becomes your total number of possibilities. And you want to select two girls and one boy. So you select two girls out of 5C2. And out of four boys, you select one boy, 4C1. So favorable number of items would be 5C2 into 4C1. That is 40. Okay. Next, five red balls. So all are different. You have to use again the combinations formula, the selection formula that we have been doing so far, NCR. Five different red balls, three different black balls, and two different white balls. If three balls are selected, find the probability that they are of the same color. Okay, so what would be the total number of outcomes? You have a total of 5 plus 3 plus 2, 10 balls, and you need to select 3 balls. So 10c3 would be your total number of outcomes. So 10c3 would be 10 factorial divided by 3 factorial, 7 factorial. So you can write that as 10 into 9 into 8 divided by 3 factorial, and that turns out to be 120. Next, the three balls selected could be either all red or all black, or all black. They cannot be all white balls because you have only two white balls. Okay, so if the selected balls are all red balls, then they would be selected in 5C3 ways. And if they are all black balls, then they would be selected in 3C3 ways. That's only one way. So 5C3 plus 3C3 becomes your favorable number of outcomes. 5C3 plus 3C3 divided by 12C3. Sorry, 10C3. So 5C3 plus 3C3 divided by 120. That gives you 10 plus 1 by 120. That is 11 by 120. Option number one. Option number one should be your answer. Write this down. Total number of outcomes 10c3. Favorable outcomes would be either all red or all black. If they are all red, that's 5c3. If they are all black, that is 3c3. I hope this is fine. Let's move to the next question. Question number 12. It's a more tricky question now. Total outcomes is easy to choose, but favorable outcomes you have to think. What is the probability that the selected numbers are consecutive? Okay, so total number of outcomes, you have a total of 7 numbers, so 7c3 becomes 35. And the possible ways of picking 3 consecutive numbers, now what would they be? See, you have numbers 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. They need to be consecutive. So the 3 numbers can be 2, 3, 4, or 3, 4, 5. Or 4, 5, 6, or 5, 6, 7, or 6, 7, 8. These are, you can write this carefully in your copy. The consecutive numbers could be 2 3 4 or 3 4 5 or 4 5 6 or 5 6 7 or 6 7 8. So you get five possibilities where the three selected numbers are conjugated. So the required probability would be 5 favorable divided by 35 total, that is 1 by 7. This is choice number one. So the solutions are very, very short, but it's got a lot of concept in the questions. I hope you are taking down all these notes. These are all just different question types. And again, I repeat, the base over here is permutations combinations. So if today's class is turning out to be a little difficult, you go back to your permutations and combinations concept and notes. Take a look at basic selections, that is NCR rule. Take a look at dependent and independent events, that is the AND rule and the OR rule. Take a look at the fundamental rule of counting, that is if a coin is tossed, there are two possible outcomes. If another coin is tossed, another two outcomes, and so on. Okay, these three things. In fact, even if you are understanding today's class, I would say you go and revise these three things. NCR, AND rule and OR rule for dependent and independent events, and fundamental rule of counting. Go and like look at these again after today's class. And let's move to the next question. This question is similar to. Okay, first you try it out. A bag contains 10 fruits, of which 4 are spoiled. If 3 fruits are chosen at random, find probability that at least one of the fruits is good. Chal. See, the three fruits that are chosen, they can be all spoiled, or how to say this? The three fruits that are selected, it is possible that none of them is good, or one of them is good, or two of them are good, or all three are good. And what do you want? You want at least one of the fruits is good, that is one good or two good or three good. Okay, so can I say that that would be total number of ways minus zero good, total number of ways minus or total number of ways minus number of ways in which none of the fruits is good from the three selected fruits. Okay, or you can write this as 1 minus probability that no fruit is good. Okay. At least one fruit is good probability will be equal to 1 minus probability that no fruit is good. Yes. Now, no fruit is good means out of 10 fruits, select 3. So 10C3 is the total number of outcomes. 10C3 is the total number of outcomes. And no fruit is good means you select the three fruits from the spoiled fruits. So 4C3. Okay. No fruit is good means all three fruits are spoiled. So you select the three fruits from the spoiled fruits. So that's 4C3. So you get 1 minus 4C3 divided by 10C3. So 4c3 is 4 and 10c3 is 120. So 4 by 120 is 1 by 30. So 1 minus 1 by 30 is 29 divided by 30. So this is a very practical example actually, that if you are going to a vegetable store and this is the case where 40% of them are spoiled, then if you select three fruits, then probability that at least one of the fruit is good is actually very high. But the problem is that if you are buying only three fruits and even if one of them is spoiled, you are still wasting 33% of your money, 33.3% of your money. So as a practical case, it is not very good that 40% of the fruits may be spoiled. Just giving a different perspective to this question. So this is where we stop for today's class. In today's class, we have discussed probability, its basics, and the range in which a probability may lie. What is a completely certain event and what is a completely unlikely event. And then we have solved some questions. We have seen how total number of outcomes can be calculated and how favorable number of outcomes can be calculated. Next time we will continue. We'll again start with some questions of easy category and then proceed to difficult. We will also look at another one or two concepts that are pending. So on that note, I will sign off. I hope today's class was okay for you and you were comfortable. If not, there is a chat option on the side to your the left of the screen probably, or right, where you can put in your queries and we will get back to you. So thank you for your time.